So hi, this is Raphael Freeman from Run Our Type Setting, and in this video we're going to look at how to make an H dot. Now you can see on this text over here we have this word ruach, and I have temporarily done an H dot in the Brill font. The Brill font has H dots, but the thing is I don't want it in Brill. I actually want the font to be this font called Arno Pro Semi Bold Italic. So how do we go about creating an H dot for Arno semi-bold italic? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna use this great little piece of software called IndieScript. Now you can use Indie Font Pro. There's a free version which allows you to make just one character, which is great for doing bullets. But this is the full version. And in order to create it, what you do is you create a new blank document and you just run the Indie Font. And you give it a name. It's already put it in Arno.semibold, because I typed it in before. And we add the letters, the characters that we want. And what we're going to do is we're going to do an H and a capital H. And then I'm going to type an H dot and a capital H dot. Now, I've reprogrammed my keyboard to type H dots. So that makes it a little bit easier. So then we just press plus, okay? And here we can see the letters that are going to be added to this new font. Now you could put all this information here, I'm not going to actually bother. And then I'm going to use as a sample font, I'm actually going to find, if I can, I don't always manage, Arno Pro, and I want to choose, I'm actually going to start with the semi-bold italic, let's just start with the right font that we want. And we do create. And what it's going to do, it's going to create now four pages, okay? The H, the lowercase h, the capital H dot below, where it's put in a square, because it doesn't have that character, and the H dot below. Great! So now how are we going to create this? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to type a capital H. Now, I'm expecting in the future, by the way, if you can't see it, don't worry, we're going to make it bigger in a moment. I expect in the future that I'm going to be adding other characters. So I'm going to start by making this 1,000 points, and I'm going to choose the right typeface, okay? So I'm going to make it semi-bold italic, okay? And then I'm going to make a paragraph style for this little letter, let's call it character, okay? Give it a shortcut, why not? And apply style to correct selection. And I'm going to place it in the right place, more or less. It's not going to be perfect, but it's good enough. And I'm going to make a new object style, okay? You're going to see why I'm going to do this. A bit of extra work in the beginning, okay? I'll call this character as well. Why not? Doesn't really matter, okay? And then I'm going to use a new feature, which is in CC 2015, size and position. And I'm going to say, I want you to position it exactly there. Just why not make it easier when we're doing it? And the paragraph style, I'm going to apply the character paragraph style. Okay, and there we go. So now what we've done is we've created the letter H. We've done quite a bit of work in order to do that. And now I'm going to make a box, this very strange box. Now what I'm also going to need, I'm going to need my dot. So whilst I'm here, I'm going to take this H and I'm going to take the italic version of this, which I've actually created with a dot. I've already done this before. And of course it didn't fit, but hang on. Just bear with me. Okay. Otherwise, I usually take the dot on the letter I, but I've already created this this character, this dot here, and I'm going to now copy and paste that dot out. So I've got a dot, and I'm going to get rid of that. So I needed a dot, and we're going to use that in a moment. In fact, what I'm going to do is I'm going to be even more sensible, to be even more accurate, just draw some guidelines here. So using my previously created dot, I'll have, so we don't have things too much off, okay? So we have the bold version. Now when we're doing bold, we probably want it to be a little bit bigger, right? Just a little bit bolder. Okay, we can get rid of this now. So this is the letter H, remember. So now I take all this, copy, go into my H dot below. Now this is a very critical part. Why did we make this big square up here? This is so we can move this guide to the right place for kerning, for purpose of kerning. And then we can get rid of this, and then we turn this and we have to convert this to curves. We go back to the H, get rid of that. And I might as well keep the H inside the font. Why not? Now we're going to do the letter lowercase h. So I'm going to do a little h there. It's tiny weeny. Apply the paragraph, the object style. Put it in the right place. Again, draw a little square over here. Okay. And I'm going to copy the whole thing to the h dot below. Okay. Then I can use the top square to adjust the right side bearing. And then go back to this H dot where we have that little dot over here. And place it in place, the exact same place, and then more or less organize it where we want. And now we've actually created the font. That's it. That's all we need to do. Oh, we need to get rid of that. And then just go through each letter. We might add other matters. You might want to have D dots and S dots and Q dots and K dots. No such thing as a Q dot. I've converted everything this to curves, and now I'm going to save this InDesign file in my composite font work. And I'm going to call this Arno dot semi bold, so that afterwards, if I want to add more letters, I can do that easily. And now I need to create the font. So how do I do that? I run InDescript font again. I'm going to run it again. This time I could add more letters and continue. But here I'm just going to export the font, okay? Unfortunately, it's not... Oh, it's remembering where I keep it, so that's great. It's remembering composite font work. And it's been created, and the software will actually open up the folder for me. And now I have an Arno dot... I should have somewhere. Arno dot semi-bold. Now, I've given it the wrong name. It should have been semi-bold italic. Oopsie-daisy. So let's put that away, okay? And let's see what I went wrong here. Let's go back into InDescript bold. InDescript, okay. Should have been called semi-bold italic. That's a bit of a mistake there. Okay. So now this has been updated, and now we just run it again. And make the OTF font. Okay. Put it in the same place. It's been created, and now we've got the right name, hopefully. Here we go. Semi-bold italic, and now we're going to install the font, okay? Font is now installed, and if we've got any luck, when we go to our book here, we can now choose this, and we can now take the character panel now and see if Arno dot semi-bold italic now works, and there you go. That is how to create very quickly, well, in 7 minutes, H dots for your font. Now, the idea, the way you should really use this feature, the way they want you to use it, is to use a very useful feature in InDesign called composite fonts. And when you use composite fonts, you can create a font where the H dot version of the font. So I've created this as a separate font called Arno dot, which is different from Arno Pro, okay? Using composite fonts, you can combine this all together. However, the composite font feature does not work in the Middle Eastern version of InDesign. So that's not very useful because I need to have Hebrew in this document as well. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. And if you have any questions, please feel free to post them below.